The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome all to another excellent edition of the Power Trading Hour. It doesn't matter whether you're in or on the Isle of Man or Saipan or even in the Sudan. We like to come to you at this time.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
So what do we have? Well, the market's up today a little bit. 3801 is what I've got for the S&P. Energy's a little less than came down. Be interesting how this market closed. We've had several days where selling came in kind of late in the day. People bought it in the morning and sold it in the afternoon. Be very interesting if we can hold this by the end of the day. I think from looking at a lot of charts over the last week, I think we're within probably by the end of next week, we probably should have some kind of top in. And that's just based on the huge amount of distribution I continue to see in the markets. Doesn't look like there's a lot of buying out there. But we shall see. It always comes out of somewhere where you don't quite think it's going to come. Dow's up 144, Nasdaq's up 193. Russell's up 26. Again, a lot of talk about government spending coming in and watching that TLT fairly closely, 152.26. I'm expecting that just like we fell from 158 back down to 154 on the TLT, we've got one more leg that will at least take us to 148-ish. On the TLT, and I expect that probably going to happen in the next few days. Again, a lot of discussions about a lot of spending, and there's two things that can happen. The bond market can scare people away from huge government spending, but also companies that need cash, if the government just takes it all, won't have very far to go. Now, a lot of these, the big tech companies, don't need cash at all. They got a problem with having too much of it. It is the other folks, the people, especially on the mid to lower tier of business life, that are going to need cash going forward and need it in a hurry and a lot of it. If the government soaks it all up, there may not be that much for them to borrow. And that may be a bigger thing when we look at how the Russell just keeps pushing higher and higher, would make you think that there was going to be a ton of cash out there. And of course, if there was, then why wasn't gold running through about 2200 right now? Again, I don't have a really good explanation. The only one that fits at this time is that bond vigilante out there saying that we're going to kind of stay right on the sidelines here. If a lot of spending gets going, you know what? We're going to head the other way. That's going to make interest rates go higher. And, of course, when you look at some positions like the VNQ, why the markets continue to go higher, that REIT part of the market has gone absolutely nowhere. It got around $82. Anyway, do I have that? Yeah, I think I do. Let's do that real quick. The reason I look at the VNQ and keep a very close eye on it is that over the history of big pullbacks in the market, most of the huge amounts of losses eventually came in real estate. And I'm keeping an eye on that. Now, I got to 85.14 today, back into Friday's candle, but neither Friday's candle had a lot of volume, and we may even end up with more volume on a little bit of retracement. But if you want to keep a close eye on the TLT, the other one I would look at out here is the V and Q also. What else do we do? To question about the SMHs already. See what we have here. I mean, you don't have a really big signal on that, other than the fact you've got very light volume. You're looking for about 3.8 million shares. You got about 2 million in the SMHs as we go up against that January 14th high. A lot of things saying that there's going to be there is some problematic issues in the SMHs. I would say the biggest ones are the ones that drove us up here, like NVIDIA, not doing much today, and AMD. Let's take a quick look at it. Kind of the same thing. Broke previous high, did it on lighter volume, pulled back into the trading range. I don't think these things are screaming shorts by any stretch of the imagination, but I think a lot of the stocks that dragged us up to this high are not doing their part anymore. Let's do a little bit of history. We'll be going through, if we're going to go a little higher, generally the last thing that happens is all the highly shorted stocks scream. We're going to go through those today. I had a list of them in the newsletter. We'll see how much time we have for them. But we'll be going through them kind of as we do now every couple of weeks, just to let you know where the sore spots are. Like DDD, when it had 10 days to cover, when these things actually go the other way, there will be blood. And well, I like that movie. Anyway, let's do a little history. When we come back, we'll get right into charts and answering other emails of interest.
And it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
Nothing. Yeah, I hope everybody heard it this time. Okay. As we said, equity put call ratios continue to be extremely low. They did bounce slightly on Friday. Bond vigilantes, I think they're back, maybe. And for today, am I putting a lot of weight on it? No, because it's expiration hangover day. And in this day where you only have one day to really get it done, sometimes it goes into tomorrow morning. It in the long scheme of things, these candles the day or two after expiration don't tend to be that indicative of future events. On this day in World War I, Britain suffers its first casualties from an air attack when two German Zeppelins drop bombs on Great Yarmouth and King's Lynn on the eastern coast of England. Most people don't know that there were a lot of Zeppelins running around causing havoc. They had a lot of machine guns. Planes tried to shoot them down, but didn't have a lot of effect. Of course, they were filled with hydrogen. We all know the big Zeppelin that blew up. And they fired and fired and never could really get these dirigibles to Zeppelins, I guess, to blow up. After about 6 months of working at it, they came out with tracer rounds. And, every one of them ended up being shot down. And most of them died in a fiery death. Air attacks really on cities started on this day in 1915 in England. We'll be back in a minute.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Well, it's no secret that I'm fairly bearish here. I think that there's a lot of distribution going on. You never know when the last blade of grass is going to go on the back of the camel and break it. But generally what happens, even in a declining market, and certainly one going higher, is that if you get a stock with massive short selling in it, and it starts to go higher, the exits become incredibly narrow. We've been talking about 3D Systems over the last week or so, since it had a good earnings day. A huge rocket with 10 days to cover. We brought this up a couple of times and in the newsletter. I wasn't in it, but was certainly one that had a lot. So we're going to look at a lot of other stocks that have massive days to cover. And had some good questions over the weekend about why I don't spend a lot of time on short percentages. And I'll tell you that the amount of shares outstanding is probably the data that I suspect the most of being wrong. It's probably 10 times more wrong than actually than any other data I know. It's not all wrong, but if there's something that's going to be wrong, it's going to be the shares outstanding or the shares in the float or both, and it makes it tough. Probably the easiest way is just look at the amount of shares that are short, divide it by the average daily volume of the last 30 days. And that tells you if someone starts screaming fire in a crowded theater, how tough it's going to be to get out. So looking at this. So on the first for the day is ADI, which not doing much, but still massively shorted. I don't see any signal in here that would say a play. Certainly you wouldn't want to be short the thing. First Majestic Silver. Also kind of interesting to see something that's that massively shorted. Certainly tested the previous high on the same volume. If it got up there, I think you might see it go much higher just on the massive shorts selling in it. Maybe Tom knows more about the conditions of the stock or the company, but massively shorted like we've seen some of the other ones. In those dollar stocks for gold miners. Yeah, lots of data. It's been tough. A genius, AGEN, is another hugely shorted stock. This one actually doesn't look as bad as some. Made a nice bottom with about half the volume of the previous low. The December 8th low had 3 million shares. It got within about 3 cents of it on January 4th with less than half the volume. Still moving up again. That may be one to keep an eye on. AMCX, AMC Networks. Very tough to see how this does well, but maybe they've divorced themselves from the theaters enough. But I do not know. AMCX on that. I need to look farther in. Massive shorting in it. AMRS, which is Amaris. I think this is a biotech stock. Give you a pretty good indication of when these things get going, and they have a lot of short sellers behind it. This is a little down today, but as of 10 days ago, was massively shorted. As it went above the 607, that would have probably been a fairly good play. ATHX, which is Aether Systems. This one's had some kind of 2 days where it's kind of sold off. But looks like it might be finding some sea legs down around that area. Avaya, always interesting to see this one shorted, like it's a tech stock that might have problems. Up at its highs, I'd keep a close eye on that one this week. BAM, which is Brookfield Asset Management, had a very slight decline off of 43.14 back around the end of November into these lows where it's starting to find some support. It may need to get down to 37, got down to 37.92, but again, massive shorting in that one. At the highs, BioCris Pharmaceuticals, BCRX. This one's got a ton. The downside is it's got about half the volume of the previous high at $9. That being said, again, especially at tops, it is not uncommon to see massively shorted stocks go up on extremely light volume and for a while. I wouldn't be short this thing. One, it's biotech, but two, just the massive shorting on that. You might see it move or catch volume in the next couple of days. But you enter day trader folks, that may be a good one to keep an eye on. Okay. You know, I saw a bunch of, somebody's mentioned NKTR. I've seen that in a bunch of my scans over the weekend, NKTR. Nectar Therapeutics, okay. Huh. I don't remember why it was in there. BLDR in the housing sector. Now, this one could be could be problematic, but again, way too many shorts. Keep an eye on this. It is above its 9-day. Looks like it probably at least tests 42.84. But, there's a reason why these people are short these stocks, and eventually they'll probably be right. BioMarin Pharmaceuticals, not doing a whole lot out here today. Maybe it fills that gap. You never know. Let's turn on our gap machine here. Okay. BPY, Brookfield Property Partners. I don't think there's anything in that one. Baytex Energy. CCJ, one of the reasons I was looking at it a couple of months ago was this thing was massively shorted down there under $10. It's starting to pull back. You might get your chance out here at about 11.50. If it comes back and tests that gap, but I am not in it at the moment, but the shorting continues. CCO, because it will go north of 20. Okay. Clear Channel Outdoor, CCO, $1.50. Kind of hard to see why that one, I mean, why somebody would be that short $1.50 stocks unless they're betting on it going out of business. And I think that's just a little piggy of most people. Chegg, this is kind of like a Best Buy, if I'm not mistaken. I'm going to go back and do the profile on it, check just to make sure. But I'm pretty sure this is like a No, it's not. Glad I checked. Direct-to-student learning platform that supports students on their journey from high school to college. Apparently, doesn't do any good in high school or once they get into college. It's just a journey between the two. But they're in San Francisco. What do they actually do here? Enables general sources required format student needs sites or sources written work. So that you don't get nailed to the late. Okay. Well, we'll look at this one.
If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Well, hopefully we got it. I have a monitor that's failing, so I've got to get a new monitor. It seems to turn off every couple hours. It may be something in it. Maybe I just need to unplug it and leave it unplugged overnight. Maybe it'll forget its problems, but hopefully I'm on. Yeah, hopefully I'm back on. Where's my clock? Got to find that. There's my clock. Okay, do I have everything? I think I have everything back up. What do we have here? Oh, we were talking about Chegg when we were so rudely interrupted to go to the break. It has broken above the high. Kind of interesting. I guess maybe since everybody's doing everything online, maybe they picked up some more business. I don't know a lot about it, but certainly March and May, this thing started taking off. So it's probably picking up some of the stuff around the virus. Let's take a look at some more. We got a lot out here with heavy shorting. Colony Financial, CLNY, is a $5 stock back up against resistance from a year ago. Again, not a lot of volume last 3 or 4 days, so I'd probably pass on that one. Clovis Oncology, a lot of biotechs out here with high shorts. It's getting very close to its high of about 650. What was its high? 653 back on the 13th of October. So that could literally break out in almost $8 on the previous high on that. CPB, Campbell's Soup. How can you short Campbell's Soup? Man, that's tough. I just had some tomato soup the other day. It's a cool day. Get some Campbell's Soup. Makes you feel better. But they're shorting the living daylights out of this. I'm not exactly sure why. I guess maybe more expensive soups. People looking at, what do they call them, designer, Epicurean. But it's hard for me to believe that Campbell's Soup is going the way of the dodo. But they're shorting this thing like it is. So you don't know. It's filling this little gap out here. Without much volume today. CPG, Crescent Point Energy, it's back up to resistance that goes back into February of last year. You've got some fairly decent volume, probably get up to 350, but this thing's been short for a while, starting to see some people short back here the last 3 or 4 or 5 days that are probably ending up covering. CPRX just kind of going sideways. That's always a good one to watch and set some alarms on, because if it starts moving, probably get up to $4 fairly quickly with as many shorts are in it. Cron, heavy shorting on this one. Eventually probably coming back to $8, but it may go much higher before all those shorts get out of it. I looked at it, and they continue to short it fairly far. The first, you know, you see all the ads for cars being delivered, you know, via the internet, and they just drop it off in front of you. I was driving by maybe a half a mile from my house over the weekend, and I saw one of these Carvana things. I thought it was a mystery, like Bigfoot or, you know, the Loch Ness Monster. Maybe it was something like Pets.com. Where, you know, they had a lot of ads, but nothing was going on. Well, I actually saw a trailer dropping off a car, and it was a little, like a little Tercel or something, just a small little thing. But I wonder how many of those actually are happening. Well, probably if we'd see a lot more of them if we were driving around a lot more these days, but thought it was interesting. This is back right at support. But that's about 270 again, massively shorted. So if this thing gets going, keep an eye on it. But when there's that many shorts, I just go ahead and start looking somewhere else. CVNA, Deutsche Bank. We've been talking about this one going broke for years. It seems to find its way back to $11 or $12 several times, and then start on the sell train again. Support's probably somewhere around $8 on this. But again, with everybody short, you can run it. We already talked about DDD. Let's talk SSYS. It's sister stock. Same kind of thing going on. Now, it didn't do well on earnings when they first came out, but it certainly turned around. Kind of the same thing on Stratasys. Dick's Sportings. Goods, tried to make some new highs here, did it on just a little bit more volume. Again, there aren't a lot of shorts in the market, but man, are they, if they picked a very few stocks to go all in on. Duke Energy, kind of a dark cloud cover on Friday's candle, but not a lot of volume either, so you kind of want to watch that. Looks to me like this could go back to $85, but everybody's all short in its grill too. Callaway Golf Company. Again, I don't know why I'd be shorting golf when it's the number one sport on TV these days. More popular, generating more bucks across the last 4 months than any other sport from what I read. It's up a little more, what, $27 or so. Making a little kind of a nasty doji out here today. But again, massive shorts. All these stocks that we're going through today, more than 7 days to cover. Most of them are 10 to 20 days to cover. Empire State Realty Trust Company. This is some of the stocks that, even though they're heavily shorted, look like they're being distributed. Most of these in the real estate sector give me pause. I wouldn't short this. Certainly, if you're going after some of these, options are a much better play if you think the end is nigh. But at the same time, like I said, I wouldn't be, if any of these things get going, look for a bottle rocket. Excelis, E-X-E-L. I believe this one's a energy place, is it not? Nope. Oncology-focused biotech company. Company makes tablets for the treatment of patients with advanced retinal cell carcinoma. So you got cancer, they got a pill for it. Advanced melanoma. Huh. Probably very popular down here in Florida. At support, not a bad looking chart out here and monster short positions. 2350? Take a flyer on that. I'll have to think of it. We'll be back in a minute.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I'll personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Thank you.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Directions Daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
And I got a few emails here, and I was going through them during the break. CL... XT. Catalyst. What do you think? Okay. Take a look at this one here real quick. Company focuses on delivering plant-based solutions. I don't know what that is. Solution to what with a plant? Company offers oleic soybean products, including oil and meal, also devised high-fiber wheat, improved digestibility alfalfa, and cold-storable potatoes. Company's foreign as plant scientist, changed its name, never a good sign, and founded in 2010, been around for a while. Nice big jump. Certainly you got a lot of volume on here. Looks to me like this would be a hard one to figure out. Got a couple of questions for stocks with very light volume. First of all, I've done some pretty long studies, and if you can't get about 300,000 shares a day, then it is what I call thin, and I almost routinely out of hand don't recommend these stocks. That is just because it's not tradable. You're in it, you're out of it. There is no real trades to these, and generally somebody inside always knows a great deal more about it than you, as it's up 34% today, but who knows? You finally got 1.5 million shares, but you also gapped down with how many shares? About a million shares back on the 16th. And that's, it's bad enough to be in biotech. It's worse to have a biotech stock that has no volume. So I'm not a big fan of that. Fitbit was going through a acquisition, and they already closed it. But the interesting part of it is they didn't wait for U.S. approval. They just said, well, no one said anything, so we did it anyway, which is going to be fairly interesting. We'll wonder whether or not this comes back to bite them, because generally you wait for the seal of approval to say that everything's closed. Well, I'm trying to remember who bought them now, but Fitbit is no longer, even though they're on my list. That generally happens when something is going to get acquired. They hedge everything out on the other side. Amicus Therapeutics, FOLD. Not like the old song from Harry Chapman, WOLD. That was WOLD, not FOLD. I don't know why I thought about that song, but every time I see the ticker on that, I think about that. It's one of a handful of songs they had were pretty good. They're all pretty depressing, though. I'm trying to remember if he had any songs that were uplifting. Well, I'll try to be uplifting here and say that we were looking for something less than 3.2 million shares today in the test of the, what is that, December 10th in Amicus. You got that. You got a fairly nice one here. And again, with all the massive shorts, if this thing's done going down, 2539 would not be beyond the scheme of things. You don't have to have much of a stop in that one if you like it. Taxi? Yeah, he was the morning DJ. He was also, I think he was always said that he would never drive a big car and end up getting crushed by a truck. So got to watch out for him. That's why I buy a big manly truck. I still may get run over by a semi, but another smaller truck probably not going to kill me. First Century Fox, FOXA, kind of a big reversal the last couple of days out here. I'm not exactly sure why everybody's shorting this stock. I know that a lot of people have booked, but they're booking from all the traditional media and even some of the new media. Just too many shorts for me. Yeah, it's unfortunately, I don't like stocks that don't trade much, because in a week or two, if you carry that long, it'll be back to trading almost nothing. They really generally don't disheartenly pick up. They generally have kind of like a whack-a-mole. You get volume one day in those stocks, and then that's it. And then they're untradeable the rest of the time. Geron, G-E-R-N, not a bad day on this. 2 million shares higher. You're back in there. And this again, I think this one had, I'll have to look again, but I think from memory, I think they had 12 days to cover. Looks to me like it could go back up to this double gap. I always like that for targets. That'd be about $2.05. So you look at that. Grubhub. If you're massively shorting this, I find it very interesting. You're probably, you've got the possible three gap play in this. You got a sideways action, but you've got a double gap up there in the 80 to 82 level. Actually, it went from, what did it close at that day? Closed at 83.02 to open up the next day at 78.76. That was the first part of the gap. You had a similar gap the next day. And then, of course, you've got the third gap down here and the thing going sideways with a massive amount of shorts. May have been overbought, but at this point, if it's a three-gap play, you're looking at today's low as being the stop, $70.53, and maybe it going and filling that gap back up to $83. That would be a $13 play, and I don't think you have to do more than what it's a right now, 71.36. So you'd have about an 80-cent stop. If it closed below 70.53, you want to be out of it. GSX. Okay. GSX Tech EDU. Apparently, it's not a fast motorcycle from Yamaha. Or excuse me, Suzuki. I almost got my motorcycles wrong. The back up today, not much in the way of volume out here, but I do like the retest of this below the November 20 low. That was 53.75, got to 45.11, but it's back in the range now, and it never really got any kind of close to that 23 million shares. The worst day was at January 6th, 45.11, 3.5 million shares. Again, tried to get back in the almost in the first day there on the 13th, tried to get back into the trading range. Kind of did. Second day, kind of did. Now you're back up here again, massive shorts. Another one that I don't quite understand why everybody's shorting the daylights out of it. is the company that makes Spam.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006, and like many of you, was drawn in by
Bam!
As well as
whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us, and Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and to help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab.
Bam!
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And we're back. Okay. Or my clock. Oh, my mistake on for being off. In Sago, looks like you're going to test the 12.6 million shares from the 24th, the day before Christmas. Big day on that one. With same volume today, nice candle. IQ. This thing had a nice bounce. It's going back up to about 21.50. That'd be halfway in this huge down day of the 16th. It came with 51 million shares. You don't have much volume in this one. This one's probably one of the weaker ones. Iron Mountain, we talked about this one for a while 2 weeks ago on the last big updates. Hadn't done a lot since then, but I still like the business. Not exactly sure why it's not doing better than it should. But these guys are betting that this company is going out of business, and I'm going to have to find some more out about it. But putting people's stuff in caves doesn't seem like a hard business to handicap. Either you got enough people putting stuff in there or you don't. But being that short kind of makes you think everybody wants to get out of putting their stuff in a cave, or I don't know what's going on that. It just doesn't seem like there's that much that is unknown in it. Ironwood Pharmaceuticals, IRWD, looks like about 1025. would fill about half the remaining gap from the 6th of November. So you want to keep an eye on that. What else do you have? We were talking about silver companies being massively shorted. I think I talked to Tom about this 3 months ago. Still the same thing with McEwen back down here at the lows, about $92. Don't know why that's happening. But still, massive short positions in McEwen and some other gold miners. In the meantime, sell when you can, not when you have to. We will see you here tomorrow, same bat channel, same bat time.